మాస్టర్ సివివి నమస్కారం. శ్రీ కంచుపాటి వెంకట్రావు వెంకటస్వామి రావు వాజ్ బోర్న్ ఆన్ 4th August 1868, ట్యూస్డే అట్ 10:20 AM ఇన్ ధనిష్టా స్టార్, సెకండ్ క్వార్టర్ కన్యాలగ్నం అట్ కుంభకోణం. ఇన్ దిస్ యోగా లైన్ దెర్ వాజ్ ఎ క్లియర్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్ on 10th December 1912 that master's ancestors or family and social background are not to be discussed, hence no further information will be mentioned in this regard. In the entire original literature of master, this line was only mentioned as yoga line and no other name was used by the master. This yoga line's main purpose is to make structural changes in human format to sustain unlimited supply of life wave and sustain such human format. This line is not for individualistic development. This is for the development of overall human species. Master's first wife was Srimati Rukmini Ammal, and after she left physical body in a peculiar situation, Master married Srimati Venkammal. In day-to-day matters, for some time, Master was chairman of Kumbakonam municipality and was also a contractor for railway works. Master's relation with the Theosophical Society and its members is not clear. However, Master's friend Sri Sundaresa Sarma notes provides traces of Master's communication with Annie Besant of Theosophical Society through Venkammal's astral. Master's physical involvement with Theosophical Society or its members is not clear. Supporting document is provided in the description section of this video. Though the references to this yoga line were found from the year 1910, as per the original literature, the background for this yoga line predates very far back into time. Master conducted several high-level experimentations in the human evolution process from the year 1900. Practitioners of this yoga line assume that reading Master's notes and diaries is a complex task and concludes that it's not possible to understand most of the terms mentioned in the literature. This assumption is correct to some extent and to only some parts of his literature. The terminology used by the master shall not be understood with regular meanings, but must be strictly used as defined in the literature. A few important terms one must understand to go deep into master's literature. 1 point. 1 point is mentioned as the minutest space in globular form with enormous power in it. Planes. Levels is a simple term one can assume for planes. Three-dimensional level is a physical plane. Astral plane and mental plane can be considered as spiritual planes of higher levels. Levels of MTAs is higher than astral and mental planes. Creation. Evolved present universe and all its planes with highest levels mentioned as M, T and A. For our convenience, we may conclude M, T, A is the underlying structure of creation. M, T, A is not a single developed soul or sage. The signature MTA found in master's literature can be referring to any developed soul, including master himself. Information from higher levels was shared to the physical plane under these initials M, T and A. As per master's literature, MTA provided instructions to the brains of designated persons without being heard by any other human ear. Pure memory and intelligent memory. Source of pure memory is beyond the known creation, and it was written as unbounded. Pure memory, when comes into the zodiac, becomes bounded by the limitations of this creation. Pure memory bounded by the limitations of this creation is called as intelligent memory. This intelligent memory moves on to take different forms in the physical world. As per the situation, the word memory must be understood as pure memory or intelligent memory. House stability. Each zodiac house has its own qualities. These qualities get assigned to pure memory. The name given to the combination of these qualities is house stability. Each zodiac house will have its own stability. Pure memory of higher levels, using the stability given by that house, enters the physical world along with astral body, kundalini and stability. Stability. Stability and house stability are both one and the same. When zodiac's house stability moves into born physical body, then this house stability is called stability. Stability stays in the heart portion of a human form. It enters the baby's body on birth with first breathing. Till such time, it stays on the head of the father. Main role of stability in human body is to spread the life wave coming from kundalini over all the visible bodies and invisible bodies of a human unit in a stable manner. In human form, it also has the function of transferring the quality of thought to the astral body. To take a next birth with a different physical body, the same stability returns to the zodiac to collect the required information for the next birth. Etheric body. After the birth of a child, the etheric body gets created due to the life wave flow radiating from kundalini. It exists both inside and outside of the body. Astral body. Information on the structure of astral body is not available in original literature of master. Astral body can be understood as the guiding form attached to the pure memory before it enters into the zodiac, and it stick on with the memory in all the births. Role of the astral body includes accumulation of the thought qualities in each birth. Astral body has its own energy and vibrates all the time. The quality of our thought and the mind culture reflects in the astral. Astral inhales human thoughts. Good quality thoughts accumulate as good karma, whereas bad thoughts accumulate as bad karma in the astral. Astral's re-reflection to physical body is its exhaling, and the quality of exhaling depends on the past and present karma. All this process is called astral breathing, mediums, disciples of master, all mediums of master provided their services not only in the cosmic work carried out by the master, but also in the experimentation with master's physical body in order to change human format. Two types of mediums were there. Three trans mediums whose body systems were all under direct control of the master. 749 practice mediums who perform practice as per instructions of the master. Memorandum. Memorandum is nothing but physical body and the invisible layers around it. Master's physical empowerment. In master's literature, it was mentioned that master's astral body is powerful and unique in the creation. However, before this present birth, in all his birth cycles, this power was not known to his physical body. As master's present birth physical body is powerful, it received and stored all the quantum information transmitted from his house stabilities of zodiac into his physical body. This process started from master's 15th year and it took about 25 years. Due to this process and unfavorable condition arising out of lagna position of the baby she was carrying, master's first wife Srimati Rukmini Ammal left her physical body. However, master retained Srimati Rukmini Ammal's stability with himself. Master married Srimati Venkammal during this time of his physical empowerment. To control human format, master conducted very high level experiments. Master's friend Sri Sundaresa Sharma was part of all such high level experimentations. At this height of spiritual development and experimentation, master brought a child to birth through Srimati Venkammal, adjusting the spiritual properties of the child's embryonic design to prevent formation of an etheric body upon birth. This child was named as Chandu and his intelligent memory was imbibed with the spiritual intelligence of Navatreya Maharshi. The child was made to survive with the support of mother's etheric body. However, by May 1910, the child's system was not able to function properly and the death state was occurring. As the life wave supply was needed from the cosmos for the child to survive, master commanded the spiritual bodies of Sri Sundaresa Sharma and Srimati Venkammal to trace the source of the life wave. In this process, on 27th May 1910, Sri Sundaresa Sharma was able to reach the levels of M, T and A, the highest levels in this creation. On 29th May 1910, master's own stability was supplied with the transmission of unlimited life wave by an independent route without touching the cosmic levels. Master then commanded supply of such life wave to the child and life was restored, but the child's structure could not sustain such an unlimited supply of prana. At this point, master identified that the human structure cannot sustain unlimited life wave and changes were needed. Master also noticed that the earth and the cosmic structures also needed changes to sustain an eternal supply of life wave in humans. To overcome these shortcomings with the consent of creation, Master CVV put in place the correction path. The information and the corrective actions to be performed in this yoga line were transmitted by the universe to master through an aura channel. The place of this aura channel is the aura room in master's residence at 64 Dabi Street, Kumbakonam. For better understanding of this yoga line, we suggest to everyone to read master's original literature. Namaskaram.